Hello and welcome back to the port. I'm the Gaff Major, and this is the no pay to win picks for season 25 of 1v1 ranked, which is going to be featuring tier 7 ships. So by no pay to win, it's basically a challenge that I'm set myself where I will try and complete ranked while I'm streaming, in which I will only play tech tree ships using tech tree commanders and commander inspirations, basically avoiding any of the content in the game which has required you to either play out campaigns, purchase doubloons, global XP, steal, all that malarkey, I guess you could say. It's basically the really basic stuff in game that everyone has access to, I guess you could say. So down below will be all the sections chaptered out, so you can obviously skip to the section of interest if you are interested in a particular class of ship, and we'll go from 1-1-1. So we'll start off with battleships, move on to cruisers and destroyers. See you there. So starting off with battleships, first pick, I think the Bismarck's going to be quite an interesting one. Okay, her downside is she only has 15-inch guns, but she does have quite a healthy secondary complement, which is also going to help with your DPM. Most engagements in 1v1 ranked are very close quarters, so those secondaries are obviously going to be quite helpful. Furthermore, you do have sonar for self-level protection. Downsides are that you don't really have torpedoes, and obviously you only have those 15-inch guns. Now when it comes to the armor scheme, we're only taking a very brief look at it, but it's quite generic for the tier. So your nose can resist 16-inch guns, a armor piercing, and your main armor belt is quite capable as well. But obviously the Bismarck does have that nice little benefit where she has that total back armor scheme, which you can just about see in the bottom right corner of the screen there, where it has that additional layer of armor protecting her citadel. Furthermore, the citadel is a quite cozy at waterline and below, so when these close quarters engagements happen, the Bismarck should be quite survivable, and I think that's what's going to make her quite a strong pick for a tech tree battleships. Other alternatives, I think the Richelieu is worth mentioning, basically because she has that all front up armor and armament, I should say, and the reason being is obviously the armor scheme, it's again quite generic for the tier, and when you strip it all back, again she also does have a citadel with a turtle back armor scheme as well. Now with the citadel, it looks like it's again just at the waterline, so when it comes to those close quarter engagements, fingers crossed, should be quite survivable. Just remember that your engine boost only really works when going forwards, and is a detriment to your ship if you're trying to go into reverse. So if you are planning on barrel tanking this and maybe reversing away from the enemy, avoid using the engine boost. Only really use the engine boost if you're looking to push down on the target if you need to. Also, her speed adds to her maneuverability, which might be quite helpful if you end up having to chase down cruisers or maybe potentially even destroyers. Downsides, all your secondary armament is mostly at the rear, so that's not really going to be that helpful. I think the Vladivostok is worth having an honourable mention. She has 6-inch guns, which does mean she's going to be able to hit quite hard, but she is quite big, so she is a big target which is going to be able to be basically picked off by say high explosive cruisers or things like that. However, she does have a small superstructure, so not a lot of her HP can be whittled away by high explosives, I guess you could say initially. Now with the other Russian battleships, she does have a slight downside in that her citadel is slightly above the waterline, so it does mean that it can be found, which does mean obviously you might suffer if you let the enemy get a bit too close and they start trying to do a drive-by. I think that's going to be the main weakness of the Vladivostok, but otherwise she looks like she can punch quite hard, so maybe if you can get the first punch you might do alright, but like I said, she's got a very big nose.
See, if you haven't been going on, we'd have heard that big nose.
And I think last but not least, she's almost very bread and butter when it comes to this tier. This is the Iowa. I know I'm usually going to try and stick to free picks, but the Iowa, I think, is a good honourable mention as well. 6-inch guns, really good at battle tanking as well, I guess you could say. Downsides of the Iowa is a lot of her HP is assigned to that very large superstructure, which does mean that she can get whittled away by high explosives over time because of the HP associated with that. The other possible downsides is that although the citadel is at and below the waterline, it hasn't got a lot of armor on the top, which does mean when you come to close quarters engagements, if the enemy can punch through your broadside armor, then it won't really take much for them to basically be able to penetrate into the citadel. But if you can keep battle tanking and you haven't got a lot of nose and you're small in the Vladivostok, you should do all right. So that's my top four picks for tech tree battleships for season 25 of ranked. So, moving on to cruisers, now my top picks for cruisers. Now, there's going to be a slightly larger selection of cruisers here, because obviously there's two ways you can look at it. You can either go for a cruiser that's going to give you a reasonable capability against a battleship, but maybe might sacrifice some capabilities against destroyers and other cruisers, or you can go for a cruiser that's got reasonable capability against cruisers and destroyers, but not great capability or survivability, maybe you might say, against battleships. I'm going to start off with the Baltimore. The reason being is I think she's a very bread and butter pick, the best way you can put it. She's got reasonable maneuverability, she's got an arm scheme capable of bow tanking 15 inch guns, but nothing really else. Another possible feather in her cap is she has a very small citadel below the waterline, which means that potentially you might be able to get away with being hit sometimes, depending where you're hit. But also, the downsides with the Baltimore is that she has no torpedo armament, so she's not going to be very well protected up close. Focusing on what I'd probably say would be the good, or the general all-rounder pick, I think the Hipper is going to be quite an interesting pick. Reason being is she has quite good superior HE and AP penetration, so that's going to hurt the enemies quite a bit. And she does have a reasonable torpedo broadside. She's got two triple launchers either side, I do believe. Although, yep, no, they are triples. Now, obviously, she's also got a very good armor scheme, a capable to angle and bow tank 15-inch guns as well. And when it comes to the actual inner arm scheme, you can see that she even has her own little mini turtle back, I guess you could say. So that's going to improve her survivability a little bit, and also that citadel is at and below the waterline. So generally, I think she's like the survivability choice, and she's also got that great torpedo broadside and also great sonar for finding those enemy DDs. Alternatively, we do have the Albemarle. I think the Albemarle is quite an interesting choice. She has great HE potential. Now, she can't bow tank against 15-inch guns. She can only bow tank against 14-inch guns, which puts her at a slight disadvantage. But she can angle against 15-inch guns, but beware, she does have an exposed citadel. Her deck armor can ricochet 16-inch AP as well, which is quite an interesting trait. She does have torpedoes, sonar, and radar. And so, generally, she might be quite a nice kitey build if you're coming up against say battleships, but also should give you some reasonable capability against cruisers and destroyers as well. But that citadel is big and going to be easily found, so I think the Albemarle is going to be one of those ships where she might be quite strong, but you put one foot wrong and it's going to be a very slippery slope. When it comes to general all-rounders against cruisers, I think the Cleveland could be quite an interesting choice. She's got an armor scheme that's capable of resisting 14-inch AP all-round, so that's going to make her quite survivable against enemy cruisers. And she's got a really good DPM, so you should be able to out-DPM an enemy cruiser should you need to. So I think that's going to be quite a strong pick. And I also think the Charles Martel could be quite an interesting pick as well when it comes for a anti-cruiser cruiser. The reason being is she has the highest DPM for an 8-inch gun cruiser tier, and she's also got that arm scheme very similar to the Cleveland, capable of resisting 14-inch AP round all round, making her quite survivable against against cruisers. Obviously, the Citadel has got that slight spaced armor in the middle, but obviously, if the enemy know where to focus, which would be up front where the Citadel does go up to the main armored belt, then they should be able to say pick out your Citadel. So that's something worth noting if you are coming up against a Charles Martel. So, moving on to destroyers, and I think the runaway winner as a top pick is going to be the Akatsuki. The reason being is she has the second highest HP and the highest high explosive DPM at the tier, which should mean that in a DD versus DD engagement, you should do very well. And also, you do come with a torpedo reload booster, so although you only have the one torpedo launcher, you can obviously get that to reload very quickly. I mean, that if you need to, you can stick two launchers worth of torpedoes into the side of an enemy battleship or even cruiser if need be. So I think generally she's got the survivability, she's got the DPM, and she's got the capabilities really in order to pull it off. So I think the Akazi is a strong pick. Her only real downside is going to be her maneuverability and her engines. They are exposed, so I highly recommend Quick Fix or Unstoppable. And furthermore, if maybe might be worth considering maybe a little bit of a speed build on there. I know certainly I might have to try that myself. I think another strong pick is going to be the Fletcher. Although your HP is not that amazing, you're actually below average, your DPM on your high explosives is the highest, so you should be able to really work things over. And also, you do have 10 torpedoes in your broadside. The only downside is there aren't that amazing torpedoes in regards to damage output, but 10 of them, you know, if you stick all 10 in the target, fingers crossed, that might do the work, especially if you've been setting fires on the way in. So I think, again, in a DD vs DD engagement, Fletcher's going to be quite strong too, but obviously you're going to be relying on your DPM to outwork win your HP loss, I guess you could say. But she is quite maneuverable, is the best way to put it too. I think another top pick is going to be the Tashkent, the Soviet tank. She's very tanky. She's got probably the highest HP at the tier for a tech tree destroyer. Furthermore, she's got the third best high explosive DPM. It's nowhere close to the Akazuki and the Fletcher. They are certainly way off in the lead. But in comparison to the rest of the pack, you are coming in third. So you are tanky, you have the DPM, and you also have a free torpedo launchers, which is going to reload quite quickly. So I think she's quite reasonable. Her only real downside is probably going to be her maneuverability. That is not the greatest. I think when it comes to honorable mentions, I think it's definitely worth mentioning the Lightning. The Lightning's been, or had been, one of the strongest destroyers at the tier. And so although the HP is not amazing, torpedo output's not amazing, the DPM's not amazing, she's a great little all-rounder. She's probably the strongest hybrid at the tier. She's got great maneuverability as well. And so I think if you're using those consumables, sonar and smoke, you should do all right, is the best way to put it. I think the tech tree lines that have kind of fallen to the wayside here have probably been the Germans and the French. The French just don't have the kind of HEDPM lead that they've had at previous tiers, and also the Germans, although they have the HP lead, their DPM is just getting worse and worse as things go up. So generally, I'd probably steer clear of the Z23 or the Tash and the Lefantas, unless you're very capable in those ships and you prefer to take them over others. Well, that's my top picks for the no pay to win challenge for tech tree battleships, cruisers and destroyers, and I do hope you did enjoy that, and hopefully my justifications do maybe make sense, you never know. But obviously this is all based on my opinion, and obviously your opinion may differ, so obviously sometimes the recommendation is just play what you're more comfortable in before maybe switching things up if you decide you want to do that. Well, if you have enjoyed this, feel free to give it a thumbs up, and if you enjoy this kind of content, feel free to subscribe. Until next time, I'm the Gareth Major, and back to the port.
Hey, hey, clear the way, here comes the galloping Major. Get out of the way there, you fellows, unless you want me to run you down. I guess this is the life. Now, hey, hey, clear the way, here comes the galloping Major.